Hello and welcome to Nikolai's Genetics Lessons, and today's video is going to be about how to apply a rule of probability in order to solve genetics problems. And here is a problem: if a person who is heterozygous for polydactyly, an autosomal dominant trait, marries a person who is heterozygous for polydactyly, what is the probability that they will have 4 normal children and 2 children with extra fingers or toes? So, polydactyly, this is such a genetic disorder when person who has this genetic disorder would have extra fingers or toes. And here, 4 answers to choose from. As usual, I recommend you to pause video here, try to solve this problem on your own first, and when you would be ready, you can run video again, and you can compare your answer with my answer and explanation. So, let me use dominant allele A in order to designate this genetic disorder. So this is autosomal dominant genetic disorder. So normal allele would be small a. So this is where you can make a mistake. This is first step in our calculations. So we have two parents who are both heterozygous. So genotype of the second parent also would be capital A and small a. And when we build the Punnett square, we can find probabilities for the progeny to inherit this genetic disorder. So capital A here, capital A small a here, capital A small a here, and small a here. According to this Punnett square, the progeny would have 3 out of 4 probability to be affected with this genetic disorder, and only 1 out of 4, or 25% of their progeny, can be expected normal, phenotypically normal. According to our problem, total number of children in this family should be 6, and we are looking for the probability that 4 of them would be normal and 2 of them would have extra fingers, so would belong to this genotype. And because this is not ordered sequence, meaning that we can may have different combinations. For example, first child can be normal, second affected, then normal, affected, and normal, or first 2 children affected, and then all children normal. So, as you see, I can choose many different combinations. Of course, we can solve this problem just listing all the combinations and probabilities, but I want to show you the best way to solve this problem, the way when we are going to use formula, and we are going to use formula whenever we have a sequence that is not ordered. And this is would be much easier to solve this problem and least probability to make a mistake. And here is a formula, n factorial. I will explain how to use a factorial method later. It is very easy, so do not worry about it. Divided by s is probability of the first type event, and we have 2 types. The first one would be affected, and second variant would be unaffected. So S here stands for the affected phenotype, and multiplied by T factorial, and T here stands for the second type of variant, and also multiplied by P and Q raised S and T. I'm using different colors here, so S here is the same number as S here, and T here would be the same number as T here. And this is going to be a formula that we are going to use today in order to solve this problem. And many other problems also can be solved using this formula, not necessary only genetic problems. And in this formula, P stands for the probability of event S, and Q stands for the probability of event T. So let's now put numbers in our calculations. So N here stands for the total number of variants S and T, and total number would be 4 normal children and 2 affected. So 4 plus 2 would give us 6. So we have factorial 6 on the top, and on the bottom, number of type 1 events, and this is going to be 2 affected children. So we put 2 factorial, and T stands for the number of type 2 events, and this is going to be phenotypically normal children. We are looking for 4, so 4 factorial. So now you see I'm using the same colors, so it would be easier for you to understand. So now P here stands for the probability of type S events. So what is the probability that we are going to get affected children? And the probability would be 3 out of 4. So instead of P, we put 3 quarters here and raised 2. As you see, we use the same letter, and we should have the same number here as we have here, and multiply it by probability of type 2 event, and probability is 1 quarter. So only 1 quarter is probability for a heterozygous couple to have an affected child or phenotypically normal child. So let's put this probability 1 quarter and also raised this number, so raised 4. So my additional comments would be that this number n is always equals to S plus T. So 2 plus 4, and this is what we have here on the top, 6. And probability of type 1 event plus probability of type 2 event, if we add these two numbers, would always equal to 1. So this is just a note for you in order to escape any mistakes here. So now I have to explain what factorial means for those of you who don't know. Factorial is basically means that we have to multiply this number by itself every time, reducing this number by 1. So 6 factorial 6 equals to 6 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 4 by 3 by 2 and by 1. And on the bottom we have factorial 2, that means we have to multiply 2 by 1, and factorial 4, that means we have to multiply 4 by 3 by 2 and by 1. So now we can reduce our numbers. We can cross out these numbers here, and we have the same numbers on the top, and we also can cross out this 2 and this 6, so we would have 3 here instead of 6, and we can cross out this 1 because any number divided by 1 would be the same number. So basically what we have here, we have to multiply 3 by 5, and our answer here would be 15. And what we have here, 3 quarters multiplied by itself as a decimal number would be 0.5625. And of course we have to put this 15 in front, so 15 multiplied by what we have here and multiplied by number here, 1 quarter in the power of 4 as a decimal number would equal to 0.0039, and when we multiply all these numbers we are going to get 0.03 and 29, and this is going to be our answer today. And as you see, this is answer B. So answer B is a rounded number. And this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.